Hi everyone, it's Sue, and welcome to the Take 3 July collage. This one, as soon as I saw it, I thought I needed to bring out the red. So I've got my three images, which is this one, and this one. So really, soap has nothing to do with the dancing. So in terms of sort of a theme, not going to really do it. But what I thought I would do, as I said, I'd bring out the red. So I did a little bit of a hunt around because I thought I needed something other than just the three images. What I've grabbed is this little piece of fabric, which is on the red side. And I thought that kind of went nicely with that. I also grabbed, I just found this little piece on my desk. It's not red, it's more of a pink, but I thought I might be able to fit that in somewhere. And I also have some blue washi tape, and it's just got a little black squirrel, which I thought might be useful as well. Now, I also think I might add a little bit of extra book page to the back of this page, because I think that might be useful as well. So I do have a couple of extras, so I thought we'd start with that. Oh, I do also have my Stazon Blazing Red ink and a stamp here, which I thought maybe I'll add as well. And of course I do have my Distress inks, the black. And I've got a script stamp if I need it. So I thought this page, it needs a little bit more to it, so I thought I would add a little bit more text. And I'm going to get rid of the edges because I want to get rid of that plainness, so just get rid of some of this if I can. There we go. How is everybody? I hope you're all well. We're in a lockdown while I'm recording this, lockdown again in Melbourne. It is now our fifth, which is really getting quite ridiculous. And I'm beginning to think I need a bigger house because while I'm working from home, I kind of need that extra room. It's very difficult in my craft room, which is where my office space is, because every time I have to do anything that requires online, like a Zoom call or anything like that, I have to tidy up because it looks so messy in the background, which is so annoying. So I'm kind of thinking I really need a dedicated working from home space. And there really isn't anywhere else in my house, unfortunately. All the rooms are occupied, and the living spaces really aren't suitable. You know, you can't have conversations while there's people walking around or whatever. So I'm kind of thinking I need an extra, a bigger house, which would be nice, except that, you know, can't afford a bigger house. But anyway, the woes of working from home. Lots of advantages, of course. It's nice to be able to throw a load of washing on while you're at home. That's always good. And it's nice to be able to have a hot lunch or something like that, which is a little harder to do when I'm at work because, time. When I'm working at work, lunch is usually a rushed affair. So it's always nice to have a little bit of extra time to have a lunch. Let me see how I might just pop that one there, or maybe I might pop this one actually. It just gives a little bit of a different background, that's all. Breaks it up a little bit, I think. Might pop that one there. Some of it's covered, obviously, but some of it's not. So I kind of thought I'd cover some of it. I might just pop that one right there as well. So, okay, there we go. Well, it's very thick there. It's got about four layers plus a chunk of glue. Oh well. Okay, let's just move those scraps out of the way. Now, let me see. I've got the fabric. So I'm kind of thinking somehow like so. And obviously that I'm making as my main focal point. So somehow I've got to squeeze these in. Maybe something like that. Maybe under there somewhere. I don't want to make that so obvious. So I'm thinking something like that. And maybe over stamp with the stamp. And I still have the blue washi that maybe I can pop somewhere as well. Might put that under there as a sort of an extra edge to the fabric. Okay, so cutting the fabric. Alright, let's just cut the fabric. I'm not too worried about these little edges, although I might trim those off a little bit. Now, how long do we need it? Let's have a look. About there, I think. Okay. Might just give it a little bit of a fraying if I can. I think it kind of adds to it if it is, although I am going to put a washi along the edge, so maybe I don't need to fuss too much. Okay. So, just remove those and hopefully I'll remember how I was going to have them. Okay, so I'm thinking, and now it was like that, so maybe a bit more over actually. And I will just use my glue stick for this. This glue stick's actually really quite good even for fabric. So it's a plant-based one. It's a Montmartre if you're in Australia, or you can get Montmartre anywhere else, I don't know. But it's actually not bad. They did change it. It used to be in a different container. But they have, oops, oh gosh. They have changed it not too long ago. I'm not sure why, because it was actually quite good before. Did smell a little bit, but it did actually really a good job. So I'm not sure why they've had to change it. But it's still not too bad at all. And reasonably priced as well, I think. Okay, so now I'm thinking I'm going to put this down here. Now I probably should put a little bit of glue. Now I will distress the edges. I do like distressed edges, I really do. Just gives it, just defines that edge a little bit. And the last one. That was there. This one was tucked under there. And I think I had this one over here, didn't I? Yes. Something of that nature. Now, I did have this little circle thingy, but I don't really know if that's going to fit in anywhere. So I might leave that out. Which one's going first? This one here. Something like that, I think. Maybe there. And the lucky last one. And there we'll pop some, I think maybe like that. Not quite how I had it. Can I move it still? Not sure how I did have it now. No, it wasn't like that either. Never mind. It looks okay. I like that. So just need to straighten that one a smidgen. Never seem to be able to get things straight. I don't know. I'll just put a bit more glue. Okay, hopefully that will glue. All right. So that's the basis of it. Now, let's just have a look at this stays on ink. And I might put a bit more washi, actually. Okay. Yep, I quite like that. So, now how am I going to have this? I might have it like so. Of course, it's hard to get it nice and smooth when you've got bumpy surface underneath. Okay, not too bad, quite happy with that. And we might have another one. Actually, I don't want it around the edges. I'm a bit disappointed I got the edges there. Let's just see if I can get rid of some of that. Okay, maybe here. Yeah, see, if you don't press too hard, you don't get the full effect. Never mind. The chances of lining that up are very, very slim, so I won't even attempt that. Okay. Yeah, I'm quite happy with that. Just get rid of that. Now, I do need to add a little bit more glue, so I'm just thinking I might add some of my art glitter glue just there because it's easier to get to. And a little bit here, I can see it's poking up. And I might put a bit more washi. Just get rid of that before I put my arm in it and wreck another top. Seems to be doing that a lot lately too. Sure I'm not the only one. Okay, and I think a little bit here. Yeah, I really like that. Let's just do some black around the edge. Oh, and I have not put the little thing that says July yet. And I'm actually looking on my table and can't actually see it. What have I done with it? Trouble is it's so small it's hard to spot. There it is, I've found it. Alright, let's just distress that, pop that on, and we're done. Okay, I think I might pop it just here to hide the fact that that didn't stamp. How's that? Perfect. Okay, so that's take three for July. And I will put a photo at the end of the video as well. All right. Thank you very much for joining me, and I will see you again soon. Bye for now.